guys, like, let's start with Aivar itself. What is Aivar all about, and how did you get started on the journey, both from the actor's perspective and the direction?
Well, Aivar was a story which started out in 2013, and both Vijay sir and myself were just kind of coming out of a personal accident in a situation, and the seed for Aivar started with that. And essentially, it was wanting to talk about basic small crimes and things which go unnoticed, which, I mean, you have a lot of coverage for large crimes and things and all that, but day-to-day things which happen and how all of that interconnects into much bigger ploys and much bigger plays, and how that affects us as a community, as a country, and as humanity as a whole. So we wanted to explore that, and to do that, we founded Aivar, and from there, the journey started. We developed a small pilot pitch in 2013, and we initially wanted to pitch it as a TV show and then make it as a film, but it took us this much time for it to mature and come into becoming an OTT show.
Which is interesting, because you then it probably like worked out for the best, because you got SonyLIV on board. How did that happen?
Well, we are really, really happy, because, you know, when I was a kid, Sony was the first camcorder I started to film something with. So when we are here on stage and SonyLIV is launching our show, it's something which is giving us a lot of goosebumps and a lot of happiness. It's a real dream to work with Sony. So like I said, it's the journey has been long, but it's been worth it, because finally we're here and we're launching on Sony.
So this is also your first digital outing. And I know Sanjana has some experience there, but Ashwin, I'm not sure.
I've done a web series before.
You have. So, digital is still a new platform for all of us, right? So, how has this experience been for you guys?
Okay. See, the web thing, the web platform is definitely different from movies in the sense, there's so many different considerations when it comes to, especially when you consider the Tamil Nadu market. When you make movies, right, the budgets are at a certain level. You have to cover a spectrum of audiences, what different people want. So then you have to have like a romantic portion. Then you'll need to have comedy for the sake of it. When it comes to digital space, I feel like you don't have to pander to that extent. You can let the story just unfold. And you're also, again, it's a very episodic. It's not a TV serial, but it's not a movie. But you have to provide the quality of a film. So that really is a challenge, because essentially you're shooting two films, the length of two films, and on a certain budget. And you have to keep in mind, as actors, obviously sometimes when we're in a certain episode, I'll ask Harsha, you know, Harsha, okay, at this point, is this in the beginning of episode one? Is this the opening? Is this the cliffhanger of the episode? Or how do you want it? Or at this point, is my character, has he already done all this stuff? Has this happened to him? So it's a lot more sort of things that you have to keep in track and stuff. But I think it's given filmmakers and a lot of freedom, because you don't have to go according to formula necessarily. So,
Sanjana, for you, it's equally interesting, because you've done entertainment, you know, the traditional forms as well as digital. So you've tried like different things there. So different platforms and stuff. How different was OTT as a platform, and also what is the sort of freedom that OTT gives you, which you perhaps couldn't find in traditional entertainment?
I think OTT keeps it very realistic and very minimalistic and yet to the point. And we have some kind of a space of freedom when it comes to the length of the show. Because like Ashwin rightly said, it takes you two or three films to put across an entire 10 episodes, right? So the director has the freedom to explain the script in depth. Wherein when it comes to a feature or when it comes to other modems, they have to cut it really short and try to convey everything in one film, which is like a 2 hour 15 minutes. And a lot of the creativity gets cut, or a lot of the important points which a director wants to say is not possible in 2 hours and 15 minutes. A lot of the characters get sacrificed and whatnot. So everybody is getting their own space. And obviously OTT is catering to a whole lot of theatre artists as well, who are definitely performance oriented people, and this is my first outing in the OTT platforms. I've been working on shows which are both on TV and on OTT, but when it comes to a pure OTT show, this is my first show, and I think it's a wonderful opportunity because it's in tie-up with Sony, and I think we look at it with great excitement.
Adding to what she said, I think it's definitely a little bit more democratic than films, because films, there's a certain dynasty, nepotism, market that is required, versus in this thing, a lot of a supporting cast and all the people from social media, theater and stuff like that.
Performers, pure performers are getting a lot of work, a lot of opportunities are explored. So
the advantage is you can have a wild mix of, you know, very good actors from theater, from people who have been founded on the digital web space. Then you've got film artists, and you've got like a mix of people you can go from. And this kind of thing, it can really make people stars. And you're on people's phones. So the kind of penetration level which an OTT gives you is something which is completely new to humanity as such.
I don't know, when was the last time I precisely put the TV on to watch a TV show? I'm not putting anybody down or anything down or being very biased because I'm on the web now, but I've just downloaded all the content I want to see on my phone, and I'm just seeing it on the run, on the go. Even when I'm going to sleep, the phone is on my face more than me being in the TV room or anything like that. And I'm just making sure I'm catching up on 2-3 episodes of whatever I'm watching. So that is the kind of an addiction it has created, and it's just going to increase by the time and by the hour.
Also, the creative freedom you get, Harsha, in this. One is that it allows you to experiment a lot more. And is it also perhaps a little easier to be true to the story itself? Because, you know, we all know of those infamous TV series which go on and on and on, which started off when we were kids and which are still running and so on, right? So that way, does it give you better control over the story?
A good story is a story. How you want to say it basically is how you want to say it. So you want to tell it in the length of a film, you say it as a film. You want to stretch it out into being that kind of mega series which runs for years, it runs. But OTT definitely presents a kind of flexibility. It presents a kind of, it gives you that width and breadth to expand on a story and expand on characters and really travel through a particular story and a journey. And I think in that sense, whether it's 8 episodes or 15 episodes or whatever the space, so it's the number of episodes which the story demands. A platform like this, it's very exciting for an audience to see the story as it was meant to be.
So that way it is a little more easier perhaps to stay true to the story itself, right?
Well, I guess. But see, there are films where you're true to the film as well and TV series as well. But this definitely is very exciting. To tell stories in formats which are not too long and not too short. So it's the whatever the story requires. And if you can call that being true, then probably true in that sense.
It's kind of a double-edged thing because on one hand... Oh, sorry, you were going to talk?
No.
Okay. On one hand, because it's your phone, like what she was saying, right? Sometimes you'll turn off the TV. I find I do this. I turn off the TV and I'm like, decide to go to bed. But then I'll go and lie in bed and I'll still be watching something on my phone. In a theater, if your content is boring the audience a little bit, they'll kind of stay maybe because their car's stuck in the car parking and they can't get out or whatever. They're like, I paid for this. But when it's on a phone, they're just like, I'm going to switch it off. So it can't outstay its, whether it's a scene or an episode, it's not easy because you still have to be gripping, but maybe truer than in a movie, you'll probably add a lot more diversions and distractions, songs. You know, okay, we've had some intense thing, let's cut to a song and let the audience relax and give them a breather or comedy scenes or whatever.
So. Does this also make it paradoxically then more challenging now because for the filmmakers, for the traditional guys, because they have greater competition from all of you. So do they have to really up their game?
Definitely.
Everybody has to up their game.
We'd like to think so.
Everybody has to up their game right now. I think it's the survival of the fittest. And you can even see the biggest stars in the country, like Saif Ali Khan and Akshay Kumar. They have gotten into the web series space. And the best thing about it is they give you a limited content and they make you wait for a span of 3 or 4 months. And they have introduced this new term to us, which is called binge watching. So there was nothing called binge watching when OTT platforms were not there. And now there's something called binge watching, and we all do it, like, you know, binge watch and addictively watch. In the airport, if I'm pulling my or pushing my trolley, in my handbag, my phone is right there. I don't even look in front. So that is the kind of binge watching it has put us all into.
So what's the response like from the audience, from the consumers so far?
It's been great. People have received the teaser very well, and increased no pressure on us. We have to deliver a very good show. So, yeah, but we love taking on such challenges, and that's what really creatively challenges us. When we got into making this show, we wanted to give the best possible cinematic experience and give something which is fresh and new to an audience and something more than what a usual web series can do. And also, we ideally want to break that barrier of this being regional content and this being national content.
Correct.
And this being international content.
Yeah. Yeah.
For us, we want to make a web series which can be viewed anywhere, anywhere across the world. So if we're able to achieve that kind of penetration into market, then it's great. Then you can say we've arrived.
And today, you know, either the content gets dubbed in other languages or it gets subtitled. So it does go, you know, further than the state it was in which it was made. And the one thing about the teaser that people have said is that visually and, you know, design-wise and the sound design, the music, the quality is like very cinematic. They keep using that word cinematic because people associate something on your cell phone with being, you know, and the challenge really is when your content is being seen something as small on as a cell phone or a TV screen, you have to work that much harder to make it more cinematic versus a theater screen. You can just have a regular sequence, comedy sequence, and it'll automatically seem bigger because it's a huge screen and people are like looking at it like that. So, yeah.
Correct. And a lot of focus would have to now be on the quality of the story and the, you know, the authenticity of the performances itself, right? You can't just, you know, make do with like good editing or just, like you really have to, everybody would have to pull
no,
their socks
any,
there.
Any good show has to have very good actors and a very good storyline. What are the stories and what are the shows which really stick to your head? Or what really, you know, motivates you to turn on to the next episode or watch it? Only if you're invested in it emotionally or if you're able to find a connect. So actors who are able to bring those kind of good performances, directors who are able to tell those kind of good stories, it's only those things which really, really stick in your head. And that's the unicorn. That's what we all have to try and go for, and that's what we're trying.
That's the unicorn, you said it. Also, lastly, Harsha, this is mainly for you, but of course, I would love to get your comments as well. You know, Hindi OTT has really, we all know that it's really sort of taken off in a very, very big way. Whereas when it comes to regional OTTs, and especially, you know, for a country like India with so many different languages, and we have like such diverse cultures, you go to Gujarat and the food and the culture and the way of life is so different from what it is like when you're in Chennai. So what do you think is the roadmap for that kind of regional OTT in the next coming years, months?
Well, Bombay is the gateway of India, and whatever content comes, it has to come to Hindi first. Hindi is our national language, and then we come down south. So, but that doesn't mean there's a dearth of talent or doesn't mean there's a dearth of things to do in other languages. So I'm sure like Tamil, there is Telugu, there is Oriya, there is Gujarati, there's so many languages. We are such a diverse country and you've got talent everywhere. So
what's the roadmap? That's the question really.
The roadmap is, it's like a spider's web. You just expand and then you go and you have all 26 languages across the world. So it's beautiful to be part of a diverse country which has so much like content from this country can go all over the place. And so the roadmap is reaching international waters and wherever humans live to watch content.
I think films like Bahubali have done it in the past, you know. They just put the Telugu and Tamil cinema back on the India's map in competition and in power with a lot of the filmmakers in Bombay. Like when Karan Johar was asked, will you be able to make a film like Bahubali? He said, no, I'm not capable of it. So, you know, that's the kind of filmmakers we have. That's the kind of strong scripting we have. But I think we just have to crack it with something better than the Sacred Games and then we'll be on the map.
And in regards to regionalism, right, the more specific you make something, the more universal it becomes. Everyone, you know, there's different cuisines, there's different languages, but everyone has the same core emotions. So sometimes when you pander and make things very generic and say like, this is how the entire audience, that's when they'll be able to get it. No, I think sometimes when you make something very specific, you can be like, no, I relate to that emotion or that type of feeling when that character from that state eats or whatever it is. So I think that's the key to sort of being specific, but having that thing open up.
Thank you so much for a very insightful discussion, and many, many congratulations for Aivar, and good luck as well.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure being here.
Thanks.